A card is drawn randomly from a standard 52-card deck. Find the probability of the given event, and we have three probabilities to find. Before we begin, let's describe the standard deck of cards given here. Again, we have 52 cards. There are four suits given in the rows. We have the spades, the diamonds, the clubs, and the hearts. And there are 13 ranks, or 13 types of cards. We have the twos, threes, fours, fives, sixes, sevens, eights, nines, and tens. And then we have the face cards, which are the jacks, queens, and kings. And finally, we have the aces. So for part A, we want to find the probability that a card would be a two. So the probability that if we select one card and it's a two is equal to the number of twos divided by the number of cards. So looking at our deck, here are the twos. There's one two of each suit, or a total of four twos. So the probability of selecting a two would be 4/52, or 4/52, which does simplify. There's a common factor of four here. So the exact probability as a fraction would be 1/13. But let's also convert to a decimal and a percent. To do this, we'll divide. 1/13 is equal to approximately 0.0769, which as a percent would be 7.69%. To convert a decimal to a percent, we multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, or move the decimal point to the right two places. Next, we want to determine the probability that the card is a face card, meaning it's a jack, queen, or king. So the probability of a face card would be equal to the number of face cards divided by the total number of cards. Again, the face cards are here, the jacks, queens, and kings. There are 12 face cards, so the probability of a face card would be 12 divided by 52. Again, this simplifies, common factor of 4. So this would be 3/13 as the exact probability. Again, let's convert to a decimal and a percent. So 3/13 would be approximately 0.2308. Notice how the 6 here indicates we round up, which would be 23.08%. And now for our last probability, we can actually do this two ways. We want to find the probability that the card drawn is not a face card. We'll first use just the basic probability formula. So the probability of not a face card would be equal to the number of non-face cards divided by the total number of cards, which we know is 52. Well, if these are the face cards, then the rest of the cards would be non-face cards. So the non-face cards are these cards here, as well as those over here. Well, if there are 52 cards and 12 of them are face cards, 52 minus 12 leaves 40 non-face cards. So the probability of not a face card would be 40 over 52. And again, simplifying, common factor of 4 gives us 10/13, which is a decimal, would be approximately 0.7692. Which would be 76.92%. But the probability of not a face card is actually the probability of a complement. When we have a complement like this, or the probability of not something occurring, we can write this as the probability of, let's say, F for face card with either an apostrophe or a bar. Let's use a bar. This means the probability of not F, which is equal to 1 minus the probability of F. This is true because we know the probability of selecting a face card plus the probability of not selecting a face card would be equal to 1, or 100%. So we can use this formula to find the same probability. Notice how we would have 1 minus the probability of a face card, which we found in part B as 3/13. Well, 1 is equal to 13/13. 13/13 minus 3/13 gives us the same result of 10/13, which we found using the basic probability formula. I hope you found this helpful.